Means no exam at all.
We have tests where they see, okay, you read, how well you read, how good your math is, and they also have something called national test, which I really hated when I was in school, because it was so stressful, and the teachers didn't really use it, and I didn't see the point of it. But yeah, it's very different, because here they, all the, from what I understand, all the students have some kind of exam.
Yeah, definitely, not some. Actually, we have got different tests. We take the test and then exams. Exams, they come each after 3 months.
Yeah.
It is of 2.5 hours to 3 hours long. And test, it may be of 40 minutes to 60 minutes or sometimes 20 minutes also. It depends upon the full mark. So we have got here highest mark, we call
battery
it full mark.
Battery charge is 60%.
And later on, pass mark. Yes. Means they have to deserve that mark too, so that they are eligible. Isn't it? But in class 10 and class 12, these are the final school level classes,
yes,
there is no passing or failing. There is grading system.
Yes.
So they give grade A plus A, B plus B, C plus C, D plus D, E. And if somebody deserves grade less than D, he or she has to improve the grade, upgrade the grade. Otherwise, it's difficult to get the chance to admit in upper classes. Okay, now what is your opinion about Anupam school? What should be done in Anupam to do better than this? Actually, we say Anupam is E-grade school of Kathmandu. We are very much
proud. The correct time is 10:12 a.m.
We have got the history of near about 24 successful years. And next year, we are going to celebrate our Silver Jubilee. 25 years of running successfully. Even though we might have got some lackings, what you have seen? So can you tell me?
Well, things I feel like are a bit different when you're difficult when you're trying to teach a class is how many students there are in each class. Because some of them, I feel like it's a bit easy for some of them if they don't want to participate to just not say anything or not participate in the class. So if the classes were smaller, maybe, I don't know, for half the size, it would be easier to reach all the kids in the class and help all of them. Because sometimes I feel like, especially, it's kind of the loudest kids and the ones who are saying the much who get the most attention. While the quiet ones, maybe in the back, they don't get as much help because it's hard to reach all of them when they're like 35, 40 kids in a class. So that's really difficult.
Okay, you mean, if the number of students are quite less, it will be better. Okay, that is also good. But generally, what is the system that we have to keep the number of students according to the size of classroom, right? Our classrooms are quite bigger. So its capacity is near about 35. And in most of the classes, there are 35 students. But you might have seen in one, two classes, there may be less than 39, more than 35. Any other things?
Well, it's a thing I find a bit difficult because in Denmark it's illegal for teachers to hit students. I don't know if it's bad because it, you know, disciplines them, but I find it really hard because it's very, very bad to do in Denmark. So that's very hard for me that it's allowed here, but that's the culture and how, yeah, it's done here. So if I had to choose, I would probably change it because I'm not used to it.
All right. So you mean physical punishment, right? Actually, we don't use the sticks. You might have, did you see the teachers using sticks?
No.
So sometimes they may use their hand.
Yes.
So, but there, that is rare cases. Sometimes if the student becomes a bit disobedient, it may be done. Okay, that's good. And did you visit some places of Kathmandu?
Yes, I've been to a lot of places. Especially yesterday when we had a holiday, we went a lot of places. But I've been to, I can't say the name, it's the temple with the monkeys, something with
Swayambhu, that is Swayambhu. Did you go to Swayambhu yesterday?
Yes, it's
okay.
Very beautiful. And I've also been to the biggest stupa, one of the biggest.
Bodha.
Yes.
Bodhanath, good. Alright, yeah.
And the big Hindu temple where they come and burn.
Oh, means you went to Pashupatinath also.
Yes.
means you were in the in front of the temple.
Yes.
Actually, people except Hindus and Buddhists are not allowed to go inside the temple.
No.
They can see from outside, but you might have seen some cremation ground where the dead bodies were being burnt.
Yes.
And there is one famous river also. Did you notice the name of the river?
No.
Bhagmati River. There was a river also, right?
Yeah, because I was told it was a very holy river.
Yeah, yeah, that's very famous and very holy river.
Mm.
And you might have seen the dead bodies burnt.
Yes.
Because that is our system. So Hindus,
yes,
they burn the dead bodies.
Yes, I was a bit scared because they hadn't told me that they would, that dead people came there to be burnt. And one of the first things I see when I come in is, I think it's like an ambulance, but it just carry a
dead body?
Body out. I was like, what's going on?
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so you have visited. Now tell me, what are the famous tourist spots in Denmark?
Well, one of the really famous ones, even though it's a bit weird, it's a statue of the Little Mermaid. It's in Copenhagen, and it's a very small statue, and I feel like a lot of people would be a bit disappointed when they see it, because it's made up to be this big, amazing thing, but it's just actually pretty small statue.
It's very small?
Yes.
But why do the people like to visit there? Because there is no any real mermaid.
No.
That is imaginary object, isn't it?
Yes.
Then why do they like to visit?
Because especially the Little Mermaid is one of the most famous Danish fairy tales. And I think it's just also, I think it might be a World Heritage thing. I'm not sure. And also when you are in Copenhagen, it's a good place to go out because you're by this ocean, by the sea, and it's really pretty. So I think that's why a lot of people like to come there as well.
Okay, because it's in capital city,
yes,
near to the ocean, right?
Yeah.
And what are the other famous spots?
Well, in Copenhagen there's also the palace complex where the queen lives. That's also really famous, and you can go into the middle of this kind of circle. Square thing, and you can look at all the different houses, like where the queen lives, where the crown prince lives, and where they have their offices.
Okay.
And close to me is the oldest city in Denmark. It's where I took my high school education. It's called Ribe, and it's really, really beautiful. It's I think it's actually more like a Renaissance city, but it's called a city from the Middle Ages, and you have all these small, old, very crooked houses.
Oh, okay.
And they are so beautiful, and you have the big cathedral, and it's just all really pretty, and there's like a stream coming through it as well.
And have you visited almost all places of Denmark, or still some places I left to visit?
Yeah, there are still some places I haven't been, because in Denmark there are lots of islands, and so I've been to like the big parts of Denmark. Like I've been to northern parts of Jylland and the middle part, the southern part where I live, and Fyn and Sjælland. But there are also a lot of small islands I haven't visited, and yeah, also a lot of cities I haven't been to.
And do you have any interest in politics?
Yes, I follow a bit of politics.
Means, did you cast the vote till now or not?
Yes, I haven't had at the parliament level. I voted at I don't know what you would call it in English right now.
Maybe local level?
Yeah, local level.
Okay.
Like for town council.
Oh, yeah,
and,
yeah.
Like, kind of like state.
So, what is the age bar for casting the vote for parliament?
18, yes.
Now, you say that you are 20 years?
Yes.
Then, when you cross 20, I think the election had for parliament hasn't taken place, right?
No, not yet. It will this year.
This year.
And it might happen while I'm here. But I hope it happens when I'm home so I can vote.
Okay, okay. So, which party is ruling Denmark now?
Right now it's a party called Venstre. It's like a liberal party.
Liberal party.
Yes.
Okay. So, do they have majority?
Have what?
Do they have majority, means more number of members or less number of members in the parliament? The Prime Minister's
they
party.
They don't have the majority of...
Means?
Yeah, they work together with other parties as well.
Means there is coalition government.
Yes.
Means 2-3 parties, they are joined,
yes,
and formed.
Exactly.
Okay. So you were talking about Hans Christian Andersen.
Yes.
Can tell me about him?
He's a very famous Danish fairy tale writer, and I